was consummated.
Yes.
How many know that's love?
Yes.
How many know that's mercy?
Yes.
How many know that was God's goodness then?
Yes.
And how many know He's not the same? He's the same what yesterday, today, and forever. Romans 8:32. This is one of my prime scriptures. Amen. Let's all read this together. Romans 8:32. Let's read that together. All right. Don't miss this now. He that what? Spared not his own son, but what? Delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him also? All right. Let's read it one more time. He that spared not his own son. That's the reason why God is able to release all of his blessings in our lives. Amen. Under the conditions that he has already what established for us to be blessed. Scripture says we repent, amen, and believe. We can say repent and believe. Amen. If we're not walking in obedience, we're not even on believing what ground. Amen. All the blessings are contingent upon obedience. Remember, when Israel got in trouble under the old covenant, the curses came. Amen. Plagues and sickness and disease would wipe many of them out. But when they turned back to God and cried out to God, amen, God had what? He had mercy. How many can say amen? Amen. That was how God's mercy was so visible under the old covenant until Moses, when he prayed, when God was threatening to wipe Israel out. Amen. God said, let me alone, Moses. I'm just so fed up with these folk. I mean, they were worshiping the golden calf then. God got so mad until he was at the point of wiping them all out. But Moses had seen God's mercy over and over and over. He knew that when people turn, amen, when people turn, God will change. When people repent, God will what? He will change his mind. I'm going to say amen. So Moses, amen, approached God on the basis of his what? Not on the basis of his power. But on the basis of his what? His mercy. Lord, you're long-suffering. You're what? Full of mercy. I've seen your mercy, amen, demonstrated over and over and over and over. He said, don't wipe them out, because if you wipe them out, what are the nations, amen, that fear Israel, what they're going to say? They're going to say, your God wasn't able to bring them out and take them to their land that they were promised. God appealed to God and caused God to change his mind. But he based his premises on the basis of God's what? God's mercy. Oh, he's rich. How many can say? He's rich. If he didn't spare his own son, hallelujah, but delivered him up for us all. Turn around and say, all mean all, meaning you, sister, meaning you, brother. Jesus was delivered. He went to that cross for every single one of us. He laid his life down for every single one of us. The Bible says he committed his love toward us while we were yet without strength. In due time, he died for what? Ungodly. The just for the unjust. To bring us to God. How many know that God is for you? So he didn't spare his own son, but he delivered him up for us all. Then he said, how shall he not with him? Oh, God, how shall he not with him freely?
Yes.
Amen. I'm just saying that three times. Freely. That means he wants to give you what? Everything you need. And he wants to do it what? Really.
Yes.
Really bad. How shall he not with him freely give us all things? Amen. Turn around and tell somebody, he wants to give us all things. He's a good God. He's a good God. He's, amen. Praise God. It's God's, amen. It's God's it's pleasure to give us the what? Kingdom. It's God's good pleasure. That's Luke 12:32. It's God's good what? Pleasure. Amen. I want every person that's believing God for you turn around in your employment, your jobs, your business. Your finances, I just want you, because I believe that this week is going to be the week that God is going to do some miraculous things in the lives of those that believe in Him for greater things in the area of finances. I want everybody